JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for February the 16th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower or unchanged against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It gained only versus JPY, while it underperformed against NOK, CAD, GBP and CHF in that order. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the Euro, the Aussie, the Kiwi and SEC. The weakening of the safe haven yen and the strengthening of the oil-related NOK and CAD suggests that markets continued trading in a risk-on manner yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major EU indices were a sea of green with a positive investor morale rolling into the Asian session today. US markets stayed shut due to the President's Day, while China's Shanghai Composite will be closed until Thursday due to the celebrations of the Lunar New Year. The further improvement in market appetite is in line with our broader view. Remember that recently we've been repeatedly highlighting that the COVID vaccinations, the monetary policy support around the globe, and a large fiscal package in the US are a blend of developments that could keep the overall investor morale supported. We believe that these are still the main market drivers, and thus we will stick to our guns. Anticipation of more US fiscal stimulus was bolstered even further on Friday after President Joe Biden turned to a bipartisan group of local officials to help on its $1.9 trillion US dollars relief plan. Now, among the G10 currencies, NOK and CAD were the main winners, and this may have been due to the stellar gains in oil prices. Apart from the overall risk-on environment, oil prices may have been boosted by a severe snowstorm in the United States, with a deep freeze not only increasing power demand, but also threatening oil production in Texas. Around 4.6 million barrels per day are produced in Texas, which is also the home of 31 refineries, the most across the whole US, according to data from the Energy Information Administration. So, alongside an improved market appetite, supply concerns with regards to the biggest producing state of the world's biggest oil producing nation may keep prices of the black gold supported for a while more, and thereby NOK and CAD may continue to gain, especially against the safe havens like the yen. The pound was also among the gainers against the greenback, but with no clear catalyst behind its gains. The next scheduled event traders of this currency are likely to pay attention to is the release of the UK CPIs for January, due out tomorrow during the early European morning. Both the headline and core rates are expected to have ticked down to 0.5 and 1.3% year over year from 0.6 and 1.4% respectively. Although such prints will keep the door open for an increase in the Bank of England's QE purchases if deemed necessary, we don't expect them to hurt the pound much. At its latest gathering, the Bank of England pushed back the idea of negative interest rates, which combined with the fact that the UK is going further ahead with the COVID vaccination race, encouraged GBP traders to buy more of the British currency. In our view, the same catalysts are likely to continue supporting the pound. Now, as for today's events, during the European trading, we get the German ZW survey for February, the second estimate of Eurozone's GDP for the fourth quarter, as well as the bloc's preliminary employment change for the same quarter. With regards to the ZW survey, the current conditions index is expected to have declined to minus 67 from minus 66.4, while the economic sentiment index is forecast to have fallen to 59.5 from 61.8. The second estimate of Eurozone's GDP is anticipated to confirm its preliminary estimate of minus 0.7% quarter over quarter, while no forecast is available for the employment change. Later from the US, we have the New York Empire State Manufacturing Index for February. We also have two Fed speakers on today's agenda, and those are San Francisco President Mary Daly and Board Governor Michelle Bowman. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AMGMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.